At one time or another, you may have seen a magician take a piece of rope and cut it and put it back together again. I'm going to do the same thing, but once again, I'm going to show you step by step how it's done. Before we start, I'd like to have someone from the audience thoroughly examine this piece of rope, make sure it is, in fact, what it appears to be, an ordinary, unprepared piece of rope. Would you, sir, go over every inch of that? Thank you very much. Go ahead. Make sure there are no trap doors or mirrors. Doesn't stretch or anything like that. Seemed like an ordinary hole. Otherwise, I wouldn't have let you look at it. It's just a piece of rope like you'd find in any bedroom. The secret to this trick is not in the rope, it's in a special knot that magicians have kept secret for hundreds of years, called the Mongolian hop knot. It was invented by the famed horsemen of Mongolia. It's kind of a slip knot. Those boys sometimes had to leave town in kind of a hurry. Now, folks, first step is to measure the rope carefully. You want to make sure that when you cut, you get two pieces of rope exactly the same length. Back together again, you tie a Mongolian pop knot. Here's how it's tied. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist. You know, some of you are laughing, but there's people here trying to learn. Twist, come around, and pull tight. You have one Mongolian pop knot. At this point, you simply reach in your pocket. You take some magic pixie dust. I call it pixie dust. I don't know what they called it in Mongolia, but you sprinkle the dust on a knot like this. In a few seconds, that pixie dust will cause the knot to dissolve and pop right on the floor. Where you're starting from. Now, some of you may have had a hard time seeing exactly how to tie that knot. Especially those of you in the cheaper seats. So we'll do it again. This time we'll cut the rope into three even pieces. This gives you twice as much chance to see how the knot is tied, since it takes two Mongolian pop knots in order to put three pieces of rope back together again. Am I going too fast?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry, it very seldom happens. Now, folks, remember, when you try this at home, make sure you cut all three pieces of rope the same length. If you make a mistake here, the trick's not going to work. For example, if instead of cutting three ropes all the same length, you were to make a mistake and one of the ropes a little short, the trick won't work. If you get one rope about right and the other rope too long, the trick won't work. All three ropes.
Oh my God. Well,
this could happen to anyone. So, if it happens to you, there is a way out. As long as I am teaching you the trick, I'll teach you what we magicians call a contingency plan. You make a mistake cutting the ropes, you fold them over one at a time like this, short and medium and long, and you say the magic word, sim salabim. You have to say these with a certain amount of conviction. Sim salabim. But it works. It works. It makes you feel silly,
oh
but it works. Bringing you back where you started from with one and two and three ropes. Wow. Now, back to the Mongolian pop knot. We take rope number one, rope number two. I'm going to tie these together. Watch closely. I'll go slow.
Jesus. Slow.
Slow. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight. You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around and pull tight. You have one Mongolian pop knot. Second knot is tied the same way. You may want to take notes. You take one rope, twist it around the other rope like this, come back over this way, come around, come through, and pull tight.
Okay, I got that.
You go back and forth the same way as you went in and out, and then you go in and out at the same time as you went back and forth. You twist, come around, and pull tight. You have two Mongolian pop knots. At this point, you simply reach in your pocket, you take some magic.
Pixie dust.
That's very good. That's very studious. Sprinkle the pixie dust on the knots like this. Any questions so far?
Why?
What?
Yeah. Where do you get pixie dust?
Where do you get pixie dust? Well, I grind my own. not just for economy, but for purity. But I would send the kids out of the house. Well, the pixies can make a heck of a noise.
No doubt. In the blender.
Can be distressing for the
very young.
Any other stupid questions? It's the only way we're going to learn. 2 seconds, the pixie dust will cause a mess. And pop right off the rope. Pixie dust is where it's from. Good one. Long. Peace.
Woo! Yeah! That's awesome.
Hey, you guys are a wonderful audience. So good.